Hello, everybody. This is our first day on the ship. It's a gorgeous day, sunshine. My name is Eva. I'm with Ignatius Press, and welcome to today.
There's a bunch of other Ignatius Press folks.
Hi. Hello. We're having a good time on the cruise with Steve Ray.
We're on the Aura cruise ship, and we're now on our way to Thessaloniki to see the waves breaking below.
Of St. Padre Pio. Well, the group, the director,
ready to disembark in Thessalonica.
It's impossible. And Steve's like, my people will listen to everything I say, and they will, they're good Catholics, and we are not leaving until we have Mass. And everyone's just like, they're like, okay, let them have Mass.
Bye-bye. Have a great day. Head down the stairs to go in the Thessaloniki. Bye-bye. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Everybody boarding cards in your hands. Alexander the Great. We call it Hellenistic. Hellenism is Greek. Hellenistic, Roman, Byzantine, Ottoman, and whatever you see right now. So, as you can understand, it's very difficult to find the traces. As our leader has said, very few things can be seen, but we know that Paul was here.
We had a wonderful Mass at the Catholic Cathedral of Thessaloniki, dedicated to the Immaculate Conception.
Quickly, so be ready.
pillars of the tower lit with blue lights. Next, we visited one of the most significant sites in all of Thessaloniki, which is the Church of St. Demetrius. The story is that he was a young man who fought in the Colosseums and won. And because of his championship, he was honored as a saint. And his relics are here. And many come here to honor and venerate his relics.
To do with St. Paul. And so it might have escaped some people's perception, even though we went to churches associated with St. Paul, that Rome is the city of Paul as well as the city of Peter. And a lot of people don't understand. They think of the papacy and they think of the Bishop of Rome as the successor of St. Peter, and of course he is. But if you go back to the early church, especially in the second century, you see how the church fathers described Rome, you will realize that they saw Rome as the city of Peter and Paul, and they saw the Bishop of Rome as, in some sense, the successor of both Peter and Paul. In the second century, in the third century, it was often the case that church leaders, bishops, talked about their cities in terms of the martyrs in those cities. And of course, the most preeminent martyrs in the ancient church were Peter and Paul.
Ready to go, another hour. And the big horns will be blasting and we'll be heading out to sea, to Philippi.